fighting robot. Mega Man. Super fighting robot. Mega Man. Super fighting robot. Mega Man. Hey Internet, just some retro gamer here. I've said it before and I'll say it again. I love Mega Man games. I really do. Even if they are on a tiny portable monochrome screen. And as we all know, Mega Man games aren't really known for their ease of play, right? So imagine how difficult one would be on a Game Boy, right? Well, let's find out together, because today we're taking a look at Mega Man 2 for the Nintendo Game Boy. Mega Man 2 is an action platformer for the Nintendo Game Boy that was actually not developed by Capcom, but instead developed by Japan System House, also known as BIOX, or BIOX, I don't know, something like that, and released here in the US in 1992. As for the story this time around, Dr. Wily has stolen an experimental time machine called a Time Skimmer, and jumped approximately 37,426 years into the future. That's oddly specific. Yeah, but enough about that. Apparently, there's some wily robots guarding a subterranean passage as well for, some reason.
No, okay, I guess we'll just gloss over that entire time traveling thing then.
At any rate, this is your standard Mega Man affair, using the A button to jump and the B button to shoot. You can also perform the electric slide by pressing down and jump at the same time.
Take that, physics! Ha ha ha, look at me slide! Left and right, left and right, mwahahaha!
Anyway, pressing start brings up your weapon select screen and allows you to use E-cans as well to pump up your health as needed. Not too shabby, right? And of course, let's not forget our faithful companion Rush, complete with his own set of moves. Rush Coil allows Mega Man to spring up into the air, while Rush Marine allows Mega Man to traverse the murky deep. And of course, there's the Rush Jet, which allows Mega Man to fly anywhere while he still has energy to spare.
Which pretty much renders the other two abilities completely useless.
One thing that is pretty cool was that the Rush Jet was modified in this game, so it isn't constantly moving forward like it is on its NES counterpart, making it a vital tool in your Mega Utility Belt. Definitely not too shabby. Starting up the game, we're taken to the ever-familiar Robot Master Select screen, featuring four bosses from the NES Mega Man 2 game. But, as all good Mega Man 2 fans know, there's really only one weapon we're gonna need to get through this game. The Metal Blade, courtesy of everyone's favorite robot master, Dr. Man!
Okay, Retro Gamer, just sit
well, he's
back
got
down.
That. That's yeah, I know, but yep. He's got that thing no, on his head, so he's. No. Oh,
nice
I'll,
and
relax.
Easy. There we go. That's a good Retro
He's kind of a doctor looking guy. Thing on his head.
Jumping into Metal Man's stage, it just somehow feels. Wrong. Almost like I'm playing a bootleg of the NES version of Mega Man 2. Everything just feels ever so slightly off. Everything's a little bit slower, the rooms are much smaller, the sprites seem a little too big in my opinion, and even the music, though it's trying to sound like its NES counterpart, just comes off as... not quite right. I mean, yeah, I get it, it's on the Game Boy, so it makes sense, right? But still, I felt like it was something worth mentioning.
As for Metal Man himself, well, let's be honest, he's not really the sharpest blade in Dr. Wily's arsenal.
Yeah, he simply just jumps up and down in place and tosses a few easily dodgeable saw blades at you. Once you get a good rhythm going, cutting him down to size is a piece of cake, and we're rewarded with the Metal Blade and Rush Marine. From here, we take on Woodman's stage, and, once again, the devs tried to cram a good portion of the NES stage into this poor little Game Boy cartridge. But they left out one of the trademark enemies for this stage, the robotic apes.
Oh, trust me, they're in there. But they're monkeying around in another stage, unfortunately. Ah, well, at least Woodman is still here, though taking him down is actually a lot easier than some of the other actual enemies in the stage. I bet he never saw that coming. Huh. With the Leaf Shield in hand, or more accurately our Mega Buster, we move on to Airman stage, which was probably my least favorite stage. The large floating tiki enemies don't really spawn in correctly until you're right at the edge of the screen, which makes timing your jumps to avoid their drill attacks just that much more annoying. Also, that wiggly Airman bacon is a lot stingier than its NES counterpart. It hasn't dropped a single life yet. As for Airman himself, no! You can defeat Airman! Don't believe the late 2000s internet memes! And with that blowhard of a boss blown away, we're awarded with the Air Shooter and the Rush Jet. Not too shabby at all. All that's left to do is to take down Crash Man. Hang on. There we go. What's gonna bother me the entire review otherwise? Okay, to be fair, his true Japanese name is actually Clash Man, but I'm an entitled American YouTuber with a marker, so there you go. The Metal Blade makes quick work of the surrounding enemies, while the Air Shooter is our weapon of choice for Crash Man himself. Luckily, we're able to make him into Mega Mincemeat and collect the Crash Bomb and Rush Coil. With no more Robot Masters in our way, we've made it to Dr. Wily's subterranean facility. And the next four Robot Masters, courtesy of Mega Man 3 on the NES. Top Man is our next target this time, and once again, it's a squished-down version of its NES counterpart. The Rush Jet and Metal Blade make cutting our way through the stage a breeze. The Robot Master himself, on the other hand, has definitely got some fight in him, but with some well-timed slides and a few pops from Old Reliable, we're able to turn the tables on Top Man. With Top Man's world all topsy-turvy, we then take on Needle Man, who's a bit of a prick. Ha! Actually, I'm pretty proud of that one. At this point of the game, though, the game is pretty much just throwing extra lives and E-tanks at me, so we can pretty much just blitz our way through the entire stage. As for Needle Man himself, we can easily drive the point home with a little help from our top spin attack, also known as the Pirouette of Destruction. With the Needle Cannon at our side, we then take on Magnet Man's stage. Oh, we meet again, disappearing blocks from Mega Man 2. Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I'm in a rush. There it is. Best joke in the entire world. I win. Just everyone stop trying. You'll never top that one. And of course, Magnet Man himself has been waiting on pins and needles waiting for you. So, why not return the favor with a little help from our Needle Cannon? Because why do that when our all-purpose Metal Blade seems to handle the job just as well, if not better? With Magnet Man defeated, we're off to our next attraction. Hard Man. Bear traps and bees are this stage's gimmick, but they pose little threat as long as you keep moving. And speaking of moving, why are the monkeys here instead of Woodman's stage? Hard Man loves throwing his weight around, so once again, keep moving while dodging his hard knuckle and pop in a few shots in between. With Hard Man down for the count, we're off to the boss of Wily's Castle, because, you know, we've never really left, technically. Oh, I think you know who I'm talking about. You know, Dr. Wily's right-hand man. He's got those cool shades. Mega Man's ultimate rival. Of course, you know I'm talking about Quint. I mean, who else would it have been? Proto Man? So, yeah. Basically, when Wily jumps some 38,000 years into the future, he apparently captured the Mega Man of that timeline, reprogrammed him, and brought him back to the present to destroy Mega Man. Thus, closing the loop forever. Or, you know, whatever the plot from Looper was. But with less Bruce Willis. But you know what? That within itself actually raises a bunch of other questions. Like, why do that when you could have brought back Zero or Mega Man X with him instead? Or at least their biometals from Mega Man ZX? Or do they just not exist anymore? But does that mean the original Mega Man was still somehow around? Like, was he hiding during the events of the Mega Man X series? And for that matter, where's Proto Man? Or even Bass? Or Treble? What have you done, Dr. Wily? The timeline! You've destroyed the entire Mega Man timeline!
What am I fighting for?!
Now, well, at least I got a pogo stick for taking down Quint, so I guess it all worked out. With that, we've made it to the final stage, straight out of Dali's Persistent of Memory painting, because, you know, time travel and whatnot, I guess. This stage is basically a mishmash of several elements from the previous stages. That said, this stage is just really easy. Which is more than I can say for Dr. Wily and his death turkey. Yeah, this boss is actually pretty annoying, and using the Sakugara jackhammer thing will do some serious damage, but ultimately you are going to take some damage yourself. I just found it was a lot easier to rely on ye old Mega Buster. Take down all three forms of Dr. Wily to become the Mega Champion! Oh, and I guess straight up murder Dr. Wily too. So I'd say that's a happy ending. And that was Mega Man 2 for the Nintendo Game Boy. A fun little game, but still somehow feels like a Mega bootleg. Apparently, Mega Man 2 on the Game Boy gets a lot of hate for being one of the weaker entries in the series. And to be honest, I can see why. That being said, however, I don't really think it's a bad game in and of itself. It's just different. Graphically, the game kinda looks the part, but it still feels somehow off. Which is something I really couldn't say playing the first Mega Man game on the Game Boy. And as far as the music goes, the game tries its best to sound like its NES counterpart, but at times, it just comes off as grating and overall unpleasant. The sound effects themselves, though, are rock solid. Control-wise, Mega Man feels a little more floaty overall, and slower than he was in the previous game. Outside of that, however, he controls well enough to perform any of his Mega maneuvers as needed. Overall, considering it had a different developer than the other handheld Mega Man games, it's really not a bad game, and it really doesn't deserve the flack it gets. Is it as good as the other Game Boy games? Not really. But it's definitely the easiest in my opinion. Mega Man 2 on the Game Boy gets my retro rating of 6.5 out of 10. It's not a quintessential Mega Man game, but it's still worth a play. As of this video, you can actually pick this game up on eBay for roughly around $25. If you've been put off by playing Mega Man because of how difficult the games have been, this might be a good entry point for you. As for me, in my opinion, it's a little too easy and it just doesn't hold up to the other Mega Man games, NES or otherwise, at least in my opinion. But it's probably still better than Mega Man Soccer. And if you're still jonesing for some Mega action on the Game Boy, then check out Mega Man 3. Definitely not too shabby at all. And that's all for this week's Retro Game Showcase. You know the drill. Like, subscribe, comment down below, and share out my videos. I super appreciate it when people do that. Not too shabby at all. Just like my Retreon crew. Haha, I mega appreciate you guys. You knew I was gonna go there, right? You guys are amazing. Thank you again for your support. I sincerely couldn't keep doing this if it wasn't for you guys. You guys are amazing. Thank you. What else can I say? You guys are amazing. You rock, man. As for everyone else who watches my videos, you guys are also great too. Thank you again. I really do appreciate it. Anyway, that's all from me. I'm just some retro gamer. Keep on gaming. Till next time.